This is the SAP Developer News for September 18th, 2025.
When creating solutions with CAP and following the recommended local first development philosophy, you'll know about the immense utility of initial and sample data loading via CSV files. Some of you also may know about the things to look out for when subsequently deploying data to SAP HANA Cloud. If you don't, well, even if you do, it's definitely worth reading this blog post published recently by SAP champion Miyu Yasutake. It serves as a reminder of the feature and the challenge, and also walks through some alternative approaches. Link in the description.
We're so close to reaching a huge milestone here on the SAP Developers YouTube channel. 50K subscribers. Right now, we're sitting at about 49.8K, which means we just need a few hundred more of you to help us cross that line. Now, if you've been watching our tutorials, following the SAP Developer News, participating in DevToberfest, and all of our technical deep dives, now is the perfect time to hit that subscribe button. Subscribing doesn't just get you notified of our latest content, it makes you part of this growing global developer community, a community that's learning together, building together, and shaping the future of SAP development. Here's the challenge. Let's see if we can reach 50K before DevToberfest. It's a celebration for developers around the world, and hitting this milestone together will make it even more special. So don't wait. Click subscribe. Turn on the notification and help us celebrate the big 5-0.
Hey, DevToberfest is just a little over a week away. It's hard to believe. Seems like just the other day we were starting the planning and preparations for DevToberfest, and here it is on top of us. We'll have all the fun and learning opportunities that you've come to know from previous years of DevToberfest, plus a few new surprises this year. I had a look at the calendar of content on the community the other day, and it is chock full of educational sessions that I know I can't wait to attend myself. And it's going to have everything that you need to help you get ready for Tech Ed this year. You know, Tech Ed, we're going to hear about lots of new AI innovations, changes in development capabilities, new functionality across the board in SAP BTP. And if you need to get up to speed on what some of these things are and how to get ready to learn about all the new innovations, DevToberfest is the place to be. And don't forget, we'll be running the contest again this year. If you'd like an opportunity to perhaps win an all-expense-paid trip to next year's SAP Tech Ed in-person experience, then be sure to take part in the DevToberfest contest. We'll have 10 winners from last year joining us in Berlin, and we can't wait to see who the new winners are going to be joining us wherever Tech Ed is in the following year. So be on the lookout for everything DevToberfest. Check out the community calendar so you don't miss any of the sessions, and join the DevToberfest community group so that you're registered for the contest. And don't forget to do all those validation tutorials and scavenger hunt and everything else where you can earn points for DevToberfest. So we look forward to bringing you another great DevToberfest this year. We'll see you all around the community and on those sessions on the SAP Developers YouTube channel.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to the SAP Developer News. Just a quick announcement. After a six-year-long break, UI5Con is back in Bangalore, India. End of November, early December, there's no exact date yet, UI5Con will be back in India, so watch this space for more information. Very exciting. Hope to see you soon. Bye.
Hi, I want to tell you about a nifty new little plugin supplied by one of our community members and fellow SAP employees. Mauricio has recently written a blog post about his available open source ESLint plugin for the cloud application programming model. Now, this is part of or taking advantage of an expanded effort for ESLint to focus on more languages and capabilities than just JavaScript and TypeScript. And he's using the JSON plugin that was already available and building on top of it to allow you to
parse and check the configuration files specific to CAP, like the package.json. But the additional functionality that he has added is checking for deprecated features and keys. So if you think that would be a useful addition to your CAP development environment, check out his blog post today and install and start using that plugin.